Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about how I type in other languages. Now this can be quite complicated the more languages you learn, and it can be a problem because a lot of the languages have different keyboard layouts and new things you have to learn, and you can't see which letters you're typing a lot of the time if you don't change keyboards or you don't get some stickers over the top. This generally isn't an issue on smartphones because you could just press the button and you can see it and you can just change languages quite easily. But on computer, on keyboard, it's quite a problem. If you want to type on keyboard in other languages, you normally have a few options. The first option is just to use your regular keyboard and just memorize the differences. This can only be done really with languages that use alphabets similar to your own. For example, like a Romance language if you're English, or basically anything with a similar keyboard, because then you can just memorize the differences. The problem with this is you can't see, like if you forget where a letter is, you can't see it on the keyboard, which can be a problem, and you have to memorize all these different layouts in your head without having to look, which can be quite a problem. And the next option is to have multiple keyboards, which is not really that practical, because you have to buy them, and say if you want to stop using one and change, you'll have to unplug that one to plug a new one in, which is quite annoying and not really convenient. It's also quite expensive, I guess, to have lots of keyboards lying around. Another option is to have a bilingual keyboard, where you can see two letters, I guess, from different languages on the same key. Or you can have multiple, I think. You can have three or four. Normally it's two. The disadvantages to this is normally you can only do it with two languages, and you either have to buy stickers and put them on your keyboard, or you have to buy a keyboard already bilingual. I have actually tried to do this with Russian. I tried to buy stickers, but I wouldn't recommend buying cheap ones just because they can come off quite easily and it can ruin your keyboard. And the last option is the one I use, which is a bit lazy, to be honest, but I am quite a lazy language learner. I try to find as many shortcuts as possible, or try to minimize the things I have to learn as much as possible. And that method is to use a layout that is as similar as possible to your own layout. It either already exists or you create it yourself. So here is the keyboard I'm used to, the standard UK layout. And say for example, if I show you the French layout, which is AZERTY, it's got quite a lot of differences. For example, the W and the Z are swapped. The M is in a completely different place. The question mark is where the M should be on normal layouts. And it's got lots of accents. Then we have the Italian layout, which isn't too dissimilar. It's quite similar. It's just got a few differences, mainly the accented letters and the question mark is in a different place. And finally, we have the default Russian layout, which is completely different, and you really almost no similarities at all. So first, as a disclaimer, I don't know how to do this on anything other than Windows, because Windows is what I use, and I'm not sure if you can even do this on like a Mac or a Linux. Maybe you could. So let me start with which layout I use for Russian. What I use is the mnemonic layout, and I guess if you just go to Windows without Russian and look for keyboards, you can find it there. It's basically converting the QWERTY layout into Russian as much as you can possibly, the best you can. It's very similar, to be honest. It only takes a bit getting used to. So I'll give an example of for example, if you write a sentence in Russian using the regular layout, I'll show you what that corresponds to in the English layout. So here is the regular Russian layout. And as you can see, it's kind of nonsense. That's Ya pishu по-русски. Just I'm writing in Russian. It's complete nonsense in the English version. So now I'll show you the mnemonic layout. And as you can see, it's quite similar. There are a few differences, but basically you're typing the same thing as you would if you were typing in Latin, for example. So there are a few things you need to get used to. There are more letters in Russian, so there are some combinations you need to learn. So for example, S and then C is a sh. So how this works is if you press S and then don't press anything else, no letter will be typed. You need to press something else afterwards. So if you press a space or another letter, then it will type the S. Otherwise, if you type S and C, it's a combination. So it works that way, which takes a bit getting used to. You have Y and O is your, Y and U is you, and so on. Which it takes a bit getting used to, but it's a lot easier than learning the Russian layout, which is completely different. And I did get a bilingual keyboard for Russian and English. It's just, I had a problem because I would look at the English letters more than the Russian and I would just get confused. I think I just found it too difficult, and I have multiple keyboards with, like, say for example, if I'm using my laptop, I can't carry around a bilingual keyboard with me, so it's just not as convenient. So this is basically how I write in Russian. I write with this layout and it's fine for me. I don't have any problems. And I guess it's quite lazy. If I went to Russia and tried to type on a keyboard, I'd probably have a hard time, but I mean, I could look at the keys that way. So I would probably write a lot slower, but this way I'm fine with. Next we have Italian, which is not actually that hard because all you need is about six accented letters, which, I mean, it really isn't that difficult. Instead of learning where they are on the Italian layout and switching between them, what I decided to do was I used Microsoft Keyboard Layout Creator, which is a free piece of software that allows you to create your own layouts, basically. And I can show you on screen how that works.
Okay, so this is Microsoft Keyboard Layout Creator. I'm just going to show you how it works. So basically, you have these are each letter, and you pick whatever you want for each letter. So normally, what I do is I load an existing keyboard. So I'll choose UK, which is mine. And it shows me my existing keyboard. So what I did for Italian was, if you go Alt Control anyway, it has these. So I would go to this and I would change it to. So I would have these copied and I would change it to these, for example. I would go paste that. Okay. So now I can type that using Control Alt E. But you can also do other things, like, for example, if you click on E and you go to All. You go dead key view. And what dead key does is if you type it, it won't type anything unless you press another key. So you can set up dead key and you could do something like base one. So if you type E then one, and then we'll have that letter which I just copied. Then hit OK. So now if I type E and then 1, it will do this as well. So you can basically just do as you like. You can set this up as you like, really. Any combination you want. You can also test the keyboard layout. So say I do E, it does nothing. Press space, it does normal E. If I do E and then 1, it does the accent, like I set it up. And when you're done, you go to project, build DLL and setup. And then you can install it wherever you save the setup file. It's just an exe. You run it and it sets it up.
So for Italian, all I did was create my own layout using the default English layout. And all I did was whenever, so you can select, for example, on if you do Control Alt and then a letter, it can change it. So I just made it so that if I do Control Alt W, then it's I guess an accented E going backwards. Control Alt E, it's going forwards. And I did the same for the rest of the letters. So I just screwed Control Alt and I can type the accents easily. So this way I have one layout one keyboard layout that I know already, and I can just write in English or Italian either way, and I don't have to switch. It's just the most convenient way. The only problem I really have with this layout is sometimes on Microsoft Word, if you do Control Alt and I, for example, it won't type the letter, but it will change something like it will show print preview. But other than that, I don't have problems with this. Now for French. French is quite a lot more complicated, just because they have lots of accents that you need to, well, I'm not sure if you need to be able to type them, but it would be better if you can type them. And the problem with this is it's just trying to use the default layout that I use, and adding these letters is quite complicated because there's so many. So I basically came up with a formula. So I basically corresponded each type of accent. If it's backwards, it's associated with 1. If it's forwards, it's 2. If it's up, like an upward arrow, 3. I don't remember the technical names for these, but if it's 2 dots and it's 4, if it's a combination then it's 5, which I'll show a table explaining that. So basically, if I want to type E with a accent backwards, I'll do E and then 1, and then E and then 2, E and then 3 for the rest, which I find, I guess, it's a little complicated, but I mean, I can get used to it, and I can, I guess, type in French that way. It's not too complicated. And probably would be a lot less complicated than learning the French layout. I'm quite lazy, honestly. But that's basically how I type. I hope you found this interesting, I guess. Thanks for watching.